Rough night, huh?
It's just whatever's doesn't even matter anymore.
Paul.
Jack.
Just got to the campus. Where are you?
God, it's good to hear your voice. When you hit the courtyard, look right, you'll see this fancy modern physics building with the lights on. I'll meet you inside there. I am so looking forward to this, man.
You still haven't told me what this is.
I know. See you soon.
Why 4 a.m.? Why not wait till morning? Paul had always been a showman.
Amy, call it a night. There's nobody left to convince.
If you're with that fraternity, you've done enough damage. We're being shut down.
Hey, I come in peace. I'm just meeting a friend nearby.
At 4 a.m.?
Yeah.
Paul had always been hungry for success. Driven. He made it onto a lot of those top young professionals lists. Now he was coordinating some huge project at the university. It's a big deal for him.
You made a long trip just to see a research project?
Well, reading between the lines, Paul was under a lot of pressure. He needed a friend. I wanted to help him any way I could.
This way. We're going upstairs to the project lab. How was the flight?
First class. Thank you for that. It's a step up from our van trip to Utah.
I missed that van.
I'm guessing Will's not meeting us.
He doesn't know we're here.
I knew Paul had asked my brother Will to consult on his project. Will was all the family I had, but he was difficult.
There's more to this than you're letting on. Is it about my brother?
Still worry about him, huh?
If Will did something wrong, then...
Jack, man. Look, I've been tight-lipped about this for a reason. This project we've been working on is going to change the entire world.
Why do I smell one of your long-winded presentations on the horizon?
I would never.
Oh, look. A perfectly placed presentation to illustrate the project. Now, who put that there?
Oh, shocking.
Okay. Enough joking. The lab's this way, Jack. Come on.
We'll get to your lab. I want to see your presentation. I know you love this stuff. Come on, man. Dazzle me.
Well, if you insist.
Progress. Our primary drive is a species. Over time, we have cured life-threatening illnesses. Explore the world.
Oh, good. Going into marketing spiel mode.
Don't ruin my flow. But there is one element which denies us true progress. Time itself. Now, I'm not a scientist, but here's how it's been explained to me. We've known that, in theory, a rotating black hole creates a deformation in space-time, potentially allowing travel through both space and time. Years ago, William Joyce, your brother, posited the existence of chronon particles, now known as Meyer-Joyce particles, which fill an all-encompassing field, enabling the constant and steady progression of time. Here at Project Promenade, we have combined both these theories to discover a way to manipulate that field. And the results are staggering. There's more, but that's enough of a primer for now.